half. That's a lot of time.
Sure is. And Johnson at the line again, ready to shoot, decides up, and good.
So Gate City's lead cut to four. Ferguson down to Morris. Morris looks at it, lines it up, bumps it up. It is not going to go. Comes down to number 40 of Sullivan North.
Lawson hands off the ball and over to Wade. 78-74 the score. Johnson with the basketball for North. Cannot leave the young man open. Bowen directing the traffic now for North. Passes over to Wade. 1:45 remaining in the contest. Johnson to Lawson. Over to Bowen. Bowen thought about the three. Drives. Passes off to Smith. Shot is up and in by Smith.
2-point lead now. Gate City has their lead cut by this pressure defense and by some good offensive play by North. Ferguson trying to get it up the floor. He's got to loop it up to Shelton. We're going to have a foul on number 34.
Personal foul number four on Scott Way of North. And Jason Hensley will be at the line shooting a 1-1.
He couldn't believe that. He just stood there and let the man run into him. If you're walking around and you want to give somebody a free shot at a foul, that's what to do. Just stand with your hands down and let somebody run into you.
Scott Way had five fouls, excuse me, so we have missed a foul somewhere along the way. Anyway, the young man has to take a seat. Number 14, Phelan, will check it back into the game now for the Raiders.
76-78. Hensley again called upon for some key free throws. Needs to make both of them. Good.
Hensley is the wrong man to put at the line to shoot foul shots because he is a very good foul shooter. Probably as soon as we say that, he'll miss this shot. We hope not.
Ivan, you don't want to jinx him. The shot is up, it's good. Don't jinx, you won't jinx Hensley.
Number 12, Bowen quickly up to Johnson. Johnson for North, passes back to Bowen from three. No, excuse me, passes over to Phelan. Phelan looks to Bowen. Bowen over to Johnson. Johnson from three. This time he'll bounce long, rebound.
Rebound Shelton, yeah, gonna go over to Ferguson. Hand off to Morris. Morris will scoot it up the floor. Looks down in a corner for Hensley. Hensley will drive and shoot. It will be no good. Rebound Bellamy. Back up and good. I don't see why the Bellamy didn't get a foul there.
Quickly back up the court. It's North over to Bowen. Bowen down to number 14. And it's off the hands of Phelan.
With a 6-point lead and 46 seconds left, Gate City may elect to freeze.
Timeout, Sullivan North.
We're going to keep it right here, folks, in this overtime period. 82-76. What a ball game we've seen tonight. I don't know what you would say about this, Ivan, but Kevin Morris has had a game that has been good for him. But I think that Jason Hensley has probably had one of the best games of his life tonight.
Hensley, what can you say about the young man? A great guard for Gate City, a very big asset to Coach Mason's team. Really can control that basketball. Whenever you need some good hands to put the basketball in, always put it in Jason Hensley's hands.
Here's what is amazing me with Gate City. We've talked a lot about Kevin Morris, standout player, MVP of the Powell Valley tournament. Arthur Ferguson was all tournament down there at Powell Valley. And tonight we're seeing the big show from Jason Hensley. Last night it was Chris Shelton. What can you say? Who wants to be the superstar? They're all on the floor and they're all good. Got a foul, number 14 will be guilty. Gate City will get to go back to the line.
Guess who they put on the line too?
I know. Naturally, your point guard will be handling your basketball most of the time, and that's where they went. Unfortunately for North, the point guard is Jason Hensley.
Gate City, if they hold on to the lead, will improve to 8-0 on the season.
First one's missed, and Shelton rebounds. We got a jump ball.
And North will have the ball. Look for a three-pointer this time from North. They're down by six.
They've got to throw it up. If they don't, they're not going to have a chance.
Lawson brings it in to Bellin, excuse me. Passes down to number 14. Phelan, the shot is up short. Rebound comes down to Lawson. Do not want to foul the shot. No good. Pull down to Phelan. Phelan's going to bring it back out. They're trying to set up for the three. Into Smith. Turnaround jump shot. Good.
4-point lead. 27 seconds left. Going to get a foul on number 11. And guess who they send to the line again?
Again, these are very crucial foul shots. The lead is four. Two made shots here would almost put it out of reach.
25 seconds left. What more could you ask for the final game of a tournament? First shot is no good. North will hurry it down the floor.
Johnson passes down to Phelan. Phelan passes back out to Johnson. Johnson from three. No good rebound down to Tony Bellamy.
Bellamy loops it out to Arthur Ferguson. 12 seconds left. Back to Kevin Morris. Morris trying to get down the floor and does. And they're going to get the foul. Morris will go to the line shooting 1-1 with 6 seconds left. But Gate City's lead is 4 points now. They put Kevin Morris on the line, and Kevin can ice the cake.
Morris has 31 points on the evening. We'll be looking to get his point total up to 32 or possibly 33 on the foul shots. I tell you what, Mike, these KC fans are terrific, aren't they?
Yeah, they got a big sign up going Raider Busters over there. Shot up is in and out. Not much time, 4 seconds. They'll just throw it up for fun. It won't go. Comes down to Ferguson. Ball game. Gate City remains undefeated as they have defeated the Sullivan North Golden Raiders here. Dave Mason was quoted as saying, I have one more game with DB, and then I can declare myself the unofficial winner of the Big Ten, and possibly he will also put the Highland District and the 10 under his belt unofficially this season.
Be the only coach to do so, I'd think, in history.
Yeah, I'd say so, too, but he does not have to face Science Hill, so that's good for them. As you can see, the boys out on the floor, quite jubilant about the victory. We're going to get on out of here. Hope you all have a nice Christmas holidays. Mike Van Winkle, Ivan Sanders, Melissa Blevins, and Lisa Gillenwater. Good night from North High School.
Low in the lower 30s, west winds 10 to 15 miles an hour and gusty. On Tuesday...
There's only one way to the top. Feel that victory, release that energy, and run like the wind. With fire in your eyes, shake those butterflies, and do the best that you can.
Tonight, the Gate City Blue Devils have traveled up I-81 to take on the homestanding Patrick Henry Rebels. We're getting ready for the starting lineups right now. As the number two ranked team in the state of Virginia, the Gate City Blue Devils set to take on the homestanding Patrick Henry Rebels. Ivan Sanders along with P.J. Grinzel to bring you play-by-play coverage of tonight's game. And we're going to have the national anthem.
Back to Morris.
outside the three-point line. The shot is up and good for Kevin Morris.
And just like that, the Big Blue Machine starts 3-2. And they put the press on up court. Number 22, Davidson trying to bring it up. He gets the Gill. Back to Davidson. He brings it across. It's immediately double-teamed by Morris and Ferguson. Finds Gill. Gill drives. Looks for some help to Onager, number 30. As he went up for the shot, he was fouled by Ferguson. It'll send Onager, number 30, Jimmy Onager, to the line. He'll shoot two. Foul was on Arthur Ferguson, his first. We've just begun, 3-2 the score. Onager eyes the bucket. Shot up is too hard off the back of the rim. No good. Onager will have one more. Mark. Shot up by Ottinger is again no good. This time penalty with the rebound and a foul called on number 44, John Fullen of Patrick Henry.
Last time these two teams met, John Fullen was not that much of an influence as he picked up a quick three fouls at Gate City and already has picked up number one here tonight. Arthur Ferguson working up court now for the Blue Devils. Brings it across the timeline. Passes for Pendleton. Pendleton wide open, puts the shot up. It rolls no good. Shelton tips the basketball. Pulled down by Ottinger of Patrick Henry.
Ottinger's strong rebound around Shelton. Patrick Henry playing tough underneath. They get it up to Gill, who finds number 22, Davidson. Davidson to John Fullen, who almost lost his balance. Fullen on the wing to number 40, Gill. Gill looking for some help. Finds Ottinger way out front. Back to Fullen at the three-point line in the near side of the court. Fullen will take that one. He'll get out to number 10, Crane, who gives it to Ottinger on the far side. Gate City, good job playing man-to-man with Patrick Henry. Crane has it being guarded by Hensley. Looking for some help. Crane, and good defense by Jason Hensley results in a five-second count on Crane.
Gate City's Hensley will trigger the ball in now for the Blue Devils and to Arthur Ferguson. Ferguson working it up court for the Blue Devils. To Morris. Morris from three once again. In and out. Rebound comes down to number 40, Patrick Henry.
That was Brian Gill collecting that one. Number 10, Crane, brings it across up to Ottinger at the three line. Gets to a cutting Gill. Shot up over Morris is good. Patrick Henry leads 4-3.
Basketball comes into Hensley. Hensley will bring it across the timeline. The point guard for Gate City passes into Shelton. Shelton's turnaround jumper. In and out. Tough break for Shelton. Rebound comes down to Ferguson. Gate City. Ferguson shoots. No good. And he will draw the foul from number 40 of Patrick Henry. Personal foul number one on Gill. As Ferguson will go to the line looking to tie the score at four. The Rebels up by one, 4-3.
Looks like Patrick Henry is going to go for a stall game on the offense. Going good for a good shot.
Ferguson, Eisenmark shoots, and it rolls good for Arthur. Score knotted at four, with a 5:45 remaining here in the first quarter. Ferguson, shot is up, bang, Arthur Ferguson.
Gate City just back in the lead, and it's back and forth game, 5-4. Ottinger has it, and that's a backcourt violation. They passed up court to Ottinger just inside the half court line, and he passed back to Gill. The referee's quickly spotted it. It'll go out to Gate City.
Arthur Ferguson brings the basketball into Jason Hensley. Hensley across the timeline, passes over to Morris. Morris shaking and baking. It's going to work it back over to Hensley. Hensley drives, passes back to Morris. Morris fakes, pulls up for the jumper. In and out. Rebound comes down to Shelton. Back up. Bad hit for Chris Shelton.
Chris Shelton just muscled everyone out to put the tip back in. 7-4. Davidson, long cross-court pass to Ottinger. Ottinger gets it to Crane. Crane will pull it back out. He's double-teamed, looking for some help. Finally, Ottinger picks it up. They work it back into Crane's hands. Davidson has it on the near court side, being guarded by Ferguson. Fullen has it, and it's knocked away. The pass was intended for number 10, Crane, knocked away by Hensley. Still Patrick Henry possession. They'll take it on the side, on the farthest court. Get into number 40, Gill. Gill gonna drive. Kick it back out to number 22. They find Fullen open. Fullen shot up over Shelton. Good.
Good job there by the big man just to let him go by. The score 7-6. Morris comes the other way quickly. No good. Morris took steps. Good call there by the official.
Patrick Henry staying close. 7-6. Ball is inbound to number 40, Brian Gill. Steven Davidson now has it as Gate City putting some pressure on. Back to Davidson. And they get to Crane. Crane is a stripped away.
Hilton. And the ball stripped again by Patrick Henry. Run down by, let's see who's finally going to get it. Patrick Henry's number 40 comes up with it.
They get in the hands of Chad Crane. Crane brings it up. He's at the top of the key. Looks to his right. Gets to number 22, Steven Davidson. Davidson looking for a cutting player. Gives it to Fullen at the top of the circle. Oh, looking for some help. To number 10, Crane on the far side. Crane being guarded by Hensley. Back out to Ottinger. Patrick Henry, very patient, looking for a good shot. Fullen thinks about the three, not going to shoot that one. Ottinger now has it on the far side of the court, being fronted by Pendleton. Out in front to Davidson, now on the far side. Into Ottinger, turnaround jumper over Pendleton, no good. John Fullen with the rebound, his shot, no good. Pendleton, or Ferguson, the rebound.
Down to Hensley quickly. Hensley fakes, pulls up for the jumper. In and out for Hensley. Rebound comes down to number 10, Crane, off Patrick Henry.
Both teams missing some shots. Ferguson nearly with the kickoff, and they're going to whistle Arthur Ferguson with the foul. It's two fouls on Ferguson early in the first period. And the horn sounds, number 14 for Patrick Henry. Williams will check in. Out will go Crane. Patrick Henry will have the ball. Number 22, Davidson, Steven Davidson inbounding. They have stack and they break it. They get it to Williams, number 14. Williams going to pull it way back. Looks for some help. Gets it to Steven Davidson, being fronted by Ferguson. Davidson going to drive for Ferguson. He's down in the corner to Williams. Williams has some trouble with it. Nearly picked off by Hensley. Williams chases it down to Fullen. Fullen to a wide open Steven Davidson. Misses the shot. May have been intimidated by Shelton.
Shelton gets it to Ferguson. Ferguson breaks the timeline. Passes over to Morse. Morse from three. No good. Rebound comes down to Ottinger of Patrick Henry.
Ottinger gets away with an elbow to Shelton. And they get it to hands to Williams. Williams coming up court. Breaks the half court line. They get it to number 40. Brian Gill going to drive. Shot up over Shelton. Good.
Tough shot there by Gill. Up to Hensley. Hensley on the left wing. Passes to Morris on the baseline. Pull-up jumper for Morris. No good. Rebounded by Ottinger. Up Patrick Henry.
Patrick Henry in the lead, 8-7. And they're coming down court looking to extend that lead. Number 40, Brian Gill has the ball. Over to Williams. Williams back to Gill. Being fronted by Morris. And Gill, oh my, almost a turnover to Williams. To Steven Davidson. He's being fronted by Ferguson. Looking for some help. Has Fullen at the top of the circle. Williams going to drive. Shot blocked out of bounds by Shelton.
Tony, the Terminator Bellamy, set to check into the contest now for Gate City. Replacing Arthur Ferguson. This is instant offense right here for Gate City.
Patrick Henry inbounding from underneath the goal. Long pass to the front court. Gill has it in his hands. Ottinger in the corner. Back to Gill. They work it around the circle. And it ends up in Steven Davidson's hands from three. Shot won't go. There's Fullen at the rebound. Fullen looking for some help. Gets out to Gill. Williams to Davidson. In the corner, back to Williams. Going to drive. Kick it to Davidson from three again. This time it will go for Davidson.
Patrick Henry up by four. 11-7. Hensley across the timeline. Gate City seems like it takes them a quarter to get warmed up. But after that, you better look out. Shelton, strong move, puts the shot up. In and out, and a foul will be called on number 44, I believe, of Patrick Henry. We'll have to wait and see. And indeed, John Fullen picks up personal number two. And Shelton will be at the line. Now there's two shots for Shelton.
You have to wonder, how deep is Patrick Henry's bench? John Fullen is really the heart and soul of this team. And what happens when he goes out?
Shelton's first shot is off the front of the rim, no good. Number 10, Crone, set to check back into the contest to replace number 40. That is Gill. Shelton's second shot coming up. The big man Eisenmark shoots. Good for Chris Shelton.
Deficit narrowed to three, 11-8 to score. 1:37 left to play in the first period. They work it over in the hands of Steven Davidson. Back over to Crane. Gate City putting good pressure up in the backcourt. They find Williams wide open. Going to drive, put the shot up. May have been blocked by Shelton. And the tip-in shot finally by Fullen. Good.
Rusty Pendleton to drill the basketball into Tony Bell. Presley across the timeline. Pass for Felton knocked away. Felton runs it down, gives it back to Morris. Morris is going to set the offense up again for Gate City. Passes over to Hensley. Hensley to Bellamy. Bellamy back to Morris. Morris tried to pass it, knocked away. Run down by number 10, Crone.
Crone comes out with a 2-on-1 break. He has it tipped away. Oh, my, a foul going to be called, and the Gate City fans are upset about that. Foul called on number 32, Jason Hensley. His first. It'll send number 10, Chad Crane, to the line. He'll be shooting. No, won't be up. There's apparently some confusion. Patrick Henry demanding a 1-1. They're not going to get it. Bullen gets it in bounds, barely, as the referee just laid the ball down. Shelton knocks away the pass. Crane can't come up with it. And oh my, Crane throws it out. No technical call. Patrick Henry fired up.
We've seen this before, though, PJ. Kevin Morris with the basketball back to Hensley. 47 seconds remaining. Gate City down 13-8. Hensley over to Morris. Morris inside for Shelton. Shelton against Fullen. Puts shot up. Block. Bellamy with the rebound. Rebound is pulled down by Ottinger and Patrick Henry.
Ottinger coming and hands off to Williams. Williams crosses the half-court line. Looks for some help. To Davidson in the corner. He's at the three line. He's hit one already. Over Bellamy. Shot is no good. Shelton with the rebound.
Gives it to Morris. Morris and Fuller commits foul number 3. KC will have the basketball on the side as the Patrick Henry coach quickly goes to his bench and calls on number 12, Taylor, to replace Fuller of Patrick Henry.
Also, number 42, May comes in as Steven Davidson gets a break for the Rebels. But you have to wonder, Patrick Henry playing physical, but they can't play physical if everyone fouls out.
Hensley with a basketball for Gate City. Lob inside for Shelton. Too high for the big man. Out of bounds to Patrick Henry.
Just a little bit out of Shelton's reach. But a good effort nonetheless. We're down to 13 seconds before the end of the first period. Patrick Henry working it up. Number 42 bringing it up. Kicked off by Hensley.
Hensley takes it up. Batting it for 2.
Pressure defense pays off. 3 seconds. 2 seconds. And they won't get a shot off.
So at the end of one quarter of action, Gate City up down by 3, 13-10, as the Blue Devils go to the bench to talk to Coach Dave Mason.
Bear Supplies. Whether it's a home health care need, such as a wheelchair, hospital bed, ostomy supplies, or blood pressure check equipment, you'll find it here at Weber City Drug. Prescriptions are quickly and
going over 100, and don't be surprised if the same thing happens here in a second.
As soon as Morris finds his range, they better look out because the three-point man will go on a rampage.
All right, Patrick Henry will begin the second quarter inbounding. Number 42, May, looks for some help. Gets it into Ottinger, Jimmy Ottinger, number 30. To Chad Crane. Crane being guarded by Morris, looking for some help. To May. May being double-teamed by Pendleton. Bellamy in. Morris, a turnover. Foul going to be called on who?
Let's see. Number 30, Ottinger. Patrick Henry is going to pick up the personal.
That's 2 on Jimmy Ottinger for Patrick Henry. Gate City in the bonus, and Tony Bellamy will shoot the 1-1.
So the Terminator with his opportunity to pick up his first points on the evening. Tony has been a solid player for Coach Dave Mason this year. Very tough basketball player, very physical. The 1-plus-1 shot for Bellamy. Up. No good. Rebound is loose. Out of bounds to Patrick Henry.
Number 42, May, will inbound for the Rebels. Up by 3, 13-10. Into Chad Crane. Crane comes up. Gate City putting pressure on. Over to May. May has the ball slide off his hands. Patrick Henry going to have to hurry to beat the 10 count. Crane barely does. Long pass to Ottinger. Ottinger shot blocked by Shelton.
Ball comes out quickly to Hensley. Hensley with a 3-on-2 breakaway passes to Bellamy. Slapped away by number 12, Taylor, up Patrick Henry. And he took steps. KC basketball.
KC putting good pressure. And it's paying off some key turnovers.
Morris will inbound the ball from underneath his own bucket. Brings the basketball into Hensley.